move over, rabbits. A new Australian marsupial is the animal to beat when it comes to marathon sex. Hello everyone, welcome to DNews. I'm Crystal Dilworth, here to talk about sex in the outback. Animal sex in most cases isn't really any weirder or more straightforward than human sex. In fact, behaviorist Dr. Jason Goldman has been quoted as saying, for just about any fantasy between consenting adults that might be thought of as beyond conventional sexual practices or decency as dictated by society, you can bet there's a non-human species for whom that particular behavior is commonplace. And that might be true, but a special marsupial inhabitant of Australia may be showing us up in dedication to the cause. Genetic analysis of several Australian marsupial mammals called antechinus has facilitated classification of another new species, this one named the Tasman Peninsula dusky antechinus. These animals are small, mousy carnivores that live in Australia, Tasmania, and New Guinea, with their claim to fame, suicidal sex. Yes, that's right. Antechinus males have sex until they literally can't do it anymore. Male antechinus literally train for the task of mating, banking sperm and suppressing their immune systems to give themselves more energy for the marathon act of passing on their genetic material. During a mating season that lasts only a few weeks, testosterone-fueled males engage in what has been described as an extreme form of speed mating. In that time, males attempt to have sex with as many females as possible, lasting for anywhere from 12 to 14 hours before their bodies literally self-destruct. Scientists at Queensland University of Technology say that these animals are biochemically driven to give it their all before, ultimately, the high level of testosterone triggers a malfunction in the inhibition of stress hormones. Once stress hormones begin to flood their body, the immune system of these overtaxed males begins to collapse, and the animal usually dies of hemorrhage or infection before they can see the fruits of their labor. What drives males to these extremes? Scarcity of food and sexual competition. Antechines aren't the only animals who mate until they die. Suicidal reproduction is called semelparity, and salmon, as well as some frogs, lizards, and many insects reproduce this way. But while not rare in nature, it is unusual to see semelparity in mammals, and all of the species that exhibit this behavior are insect-eating marsupials. The narrow window of the mating season is thought to follow the boom-bust nature of the insect life cycle. Synchronizing antechinus reproduction so that females raise their young at times when food or insects are most abundant. The intensity of the resulting sexual competition also works out for females who benefit by mating promiscuously and just letting the best sperm win. This anomaly of evolution may sound like all play and no work, but the inefficiency of the mating practice combined with severely reduced natural habitat is cutting each generation of the antechinus population in half. And scientists have already requested this newly discovered marsupial be placed on the threatened species list, leading one to speculate that this might be an evolutionary dead end. Is there any other weird animal behavior that you want to know about? Let us know in the comments down below. Also, check out this video with Matt and Trace to see which other animals made the list of weirdest new species discovered last year.
The so-called Supersonus produces the highest frequency calls ever found in nature, likely developed as a defense mechanism. Supersonus evolved without the ability to fly, and their tiny wings are unable to help them flee from potential predators such as bats.
Thanks for watching, and subscribe to DNews for more science videos every day of the week.